Hey, it's Tom with Contractor Fight TV. Today, we're going to talk about how you can find the break-even point in your contracting business. What I mean by that is, like, there's a dollar amount of sales that comes in, and then there's what it costs you to do all that work, and there's an amount of money left over and things like that, and then you got all your overhead and bills and all this other garbage, okay, that sounds really confusing if you're not used to looking at your numbers. But today I'm gonna just show you a really simple way to figure out the bare minimum amount of money that you need to bring into your business that helps you act like a bobber on the water, where you're bobbing up and down, you're not drowning, you're not on the top of a big cruise ship, but you're at least surviving. Because the truth is most contractors don't know their numbers. Most contractors are not even hitting their break-even points, which leads to a lot of other bad shit in their life. So check this out. To find your break-even point in your business, I want you to look at it like this. I talked about, like, you're a bobber, right? Here's the ocean and here's the bobber. And the bobber is, like, you know, just here. It's like your head is just above water. You can breathe, right? It's like you got a life jacket on, and every now and then a wave might hit you in the face and throw some water down your mouth. But the point is you're not sinking. You're not dropping to the bottom of the ocean. All right. You're breaking even. You're surviving. All right. So that's what we're going to talk about here today, is how to make that happen in your business. All right, so check this out, everybody. There's two numbers that you need. The first number that you need is gross profit. You need to know what your gross profit percentage is on the jobs that you do. The second thing that you need to know is what your overhead costs are per month, okay? Each month, what does it cost to run your business? So gross profit is found by sales price of a job minus cost of goods sold, what it cost you to do the job. So if you sold a job at $10,000 and it cost you $6,000 to do the job, you would have $4,000 left. Then you take that $4,000 and you divide it by the sale price. That will give you a decimal form. It looks like that, 0.40, okay? That's a 40% gross profit. That's how you figure out your gross profit. So if you need to look at your jobs, you know, if you haven't done it on all your jobs, you don't know what your average is, then just look at your profit and loss sheet. Hopefully you got QuickBooks or something like that. And you look at your profit and loss, and look at the money that came in, and look at the minus the cost of goods for the month. Oops, that's a C. Cost of goods. And your gross profit dollars, and you divide that by the sale price. All right, so without confusing you more, you need to know that number. If you don't know that number, it's gonna be really hard to find a break-even point. All right, so here's the other thing you need. You need your overhead, okay? So, like, what do you write down all of your overhead expenses. Now remember, overhead is anything that gets paid in the business that has to get paid in the business, even if you don't do any jobs that month. So if you got some stupid ass agreement with, like, Yelp or something, that's overhead because you're paying it every month. Marketing things, commitments, SEO guys that you've got, you know, any of the marketing stuff you're already paying for, that you're under contract for. If you have your office rent, or, you know, your mortgage for your building. So if you got rent, you got your trucks that you pay for each month. You got your cell phone bill. Hopefully you have your own salary in there. All right, you should be paying yourself a salary every month so that you have dependable income. All right, marketing. You know, we talked about that. Maybe dues and subscriptions. If you're in our Contractor Fight Club, that would be part of this, or our Contractor Sales Academy. That is a due or a subscription. Associations that you're in, Chamber of Commerce, B&I groups. I could go on and on and on. What are the things that get paid every month, even if you don't do any work? That's what I mean by overhead. So let's pretend that your overhead amount, you add it all up, is $20,000, because I know you're paying yourself 10 grand a month, right? So you take the $20,000 by your historic gross profit number. So if you're like, hey, we like clockwork, we get a 50% gross profit, then you would take the $20,000 and divide it by the gross profit as a decimal, so 50%. If it was 40%, you'd do 0.40, okay, whatever it is. In this case, it's 50%. $20,000 divided by 0.50 is $40,000. That's the amount of money you need to sell in that month in order to have the $20,000 left over to pay for your overhead. Thus, here's zero, here's 10, and here's negative 10, just to break even, just to be at zero, basically. No profit in the business, nothing like that. All right, so let's refresh this here real quick. To recap, to find your break-even point, okay, take your overhead dollars divided by your gross profit percentage. All right, so again, on an annual basis, if you know your overhead is $100,000, let's just use that for the simple math, that's what it basically costs to keep the lights on in your business. You get paid, all the bills get paid, and there's no profit left. You take that 100 grand divided by your 50% gross profit, or whatever it is, I'm just doing that for the ease of the math, that means I would have to sell $200,000 just to pay for this. Okay, Tom, what happens to the other 100,000, right? Because 200 grand, if I sell 200, okay, there's a $100,000 difference here. That other $100,000 is your cost of goods sold. Okay, your COGS, that's a really ugly C. All right, that's what it costs you to produce the work. That other half of the money, or whatever percentage it is, that's where that money goes. All right, so hopefully, guys, this helps as you're planning what you need to sell. All right, now, one of the other things that we could talk about going forward is this helps you in the planning, and that if I know my break-even point is $200,000 in sales, and I know my average job is, you know, $50,000 or something, well, $200,000 divided by 50 is four jobs. I need to do those four jobs in that given amount of time to hit my goals. All right, so hey, this is all part of creating a great profit plan for your business. Figure out your break-even point, post it in the comments below. Don't forget to subscribe. And if you want more help growing your business, head over to thecontractorfight.com.